How to Kill a Fish. It might seem like a harsh title, but if you're a fisherman, it's something that you're going to have to think about eventually, because occasionally it will happen, even if you're not going to keep fish to eat. I actually talked about this subject once in a video called Do Fish Have Feelings? And in that video, I was taught through comments proper, humane way to kill fish. And it was not just a way to be nice to the fish, but it was also a way to make it taste the best, and it all dealt with something called Iki Jime. This ancient Japanese technique for killing fish is fast, simple, humane, and even if you don't care about the fish, like a lot of people do, because in a recent video of mine, a buddy of mine killed a mullet for us to eat, and he didn't kill it first, he just filleted it up, and people kind of lost their minds. In my video, Do Fish Have Feelings, I talked about how hard it is to even think about fish having feelings if you're going to fish at all. Because just for sport, even if you're releasing them, you're putting hooks in their face, and you know there's a chance that these fish can die. But as a guy who will occasionally catch and keep and fillet and eat fish, well, there's a definite chance that some fish are going to meet their end. So this is just a warning for everybody who wants to continue watching. Some fish will be harmed in this video. And in order to do that and to talk about this new technique that I was taught through comments by people like yourself, I'm going to go and catch a fish right now and fillet it up. I happen to be in the fortunate position of living on the water, and I happen to know that there were some mullet around here somewhere, and they would be willing to participate in this experiment. Well, with a little encouragement, of course. Well, this is the part that always gets a little bit ugly. When you have a fish and you want to keep it to eat it, and you want to kill it humanely, well, this is one way. You take a spike, you find the brain, and what you do is you poke the brain with the spike. The fish will flare up a little bit, and usually very rapidly, it'll just go limp, causing that brain death. This is the end of this little fish. It's always a good idea to give thanks to the little fish. Thank you, buddy. And that's it. The fish is now ready for the fillet table. If it has spikes, you're less likely to get stung by it. And again, it is a humane way to kill a fish. I've actually done this to lots of different types of species. Here you see a mangrove snapper. This guy was above the legal limit, and I planned on keeping him and eating him. Again, I found his brain with this little spike here, and that was a quick end for that fish. You can make a spike out of anything, really. Here I'm using an old Phillips head screwdriver. I ground it down into a spike. Now it's a great Iki Jime tool. There's another example. You could use a chopstick to sharpen it up, or like a horseshoe crab tail. In this video, I'm using a different tool. And you can see this is some older footage of a sheep's head that I caught. That's its skull there. And I had boiled all the flesh away. They're pretty cool looking, aren't they? Sheep's head have very strong skulls, so the reason I boiled it is so that I could find out what's the easiest way to get to its brain cavity. Sticking it from the top is doable, but very difficult. Right there in the back of the eye, there's a hole where the optic nerve is, and that passes through to the brain, which would be easier than getting to the brain from the top. At this point, I'm still just sort of figuring this out. You can see here, I have a little trouble at first. That didn't seem to help. Further back, whoa, there it is. His eye just lost focus. Oh, twitched a little bit. That should be it. A little bit of goo coming out. I think that's it. Right above the eye, slightly behind it. Kill the brain. And that's it, he should stop flopping around.
Boiling the head of that fish and revealing the skull really helped me out. I had done the same thing with redfish. That was before this guy. This was the first time I had performed Iki Jime on a redfish. I was just trying to figure out where his brain might be, where the hard spots in the skull might be, etc. Here I used a knife and I just kind of dug my way through to his brain. It killed the fish very rapidly and humanely. The more I do this, however, the more I realize that the best way to do it is to just put a spike through the eye, through the back of the eye, through that little hole where the optic nerve is. Here you can see that black drum, or the head of it, which I also boiled in order to take a look at the skull. The more you study the fish, the more accurately you can dispatch them. It's funny how many pieces parts a fish's head is made out of. It's not one big skull like a human being. It's pretty interesting the things you find. But I did this just so that I could kill the future fish that I catch quicker and more humanely. And again, this is an older video. Nowadays, I try to use the same techniques when filleting fish like this mullet here. Or a sheep's head, or a snapper, or a trout, whatever fish I decide to keep and eat. It's always a good idea, I think, to be respectful of your fish. But at some point you have to realize that we are eating these fish, so you can't really get too crazy worrying about their feelings. But I have heard your comments, and that's why I made this video, and hopefully it helps answer the question as to how I truly feel about killing fish that I'm going to eat.
All right, well, hopefully this video helps some of you guys out there who are concerned about the welfare of fish and how to humanely kill them. But I will tell you this, that for those of you who don't really care about whether or not fish have feelings, or those of you who think that fish don't have feelings whatsoever, you could also use this technique because it's supposed to make the fish taste better. Because if the fish are not stressed, well then they're not putting lactic acid into their fillets or something. And this part here, is supposed to taste better. Thank you guys for watching. See you next time.
That was good.